Well, ladies, that's a wrap on our first season as the DP's Angels. We've got a little something special in store for you tonight. Before we get started, just a quick little message from our coach.
Hi, everybody. Hope everybody's well.
Here comes our first player of the night, Laurie, our star second baseman. Laurie, what was going through your head when you were backing up in the outfield and fell? Laurie, there was one play where the runner knocked right into you and knocked your glasses off your face. How did you feel about that play?
I'm all shook up. Well, my hands are shaking and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own 2 feet.
Laurie, when Sheena showed up to a game this year without her cleats, what did you say to her? Oh, here comes one of our newbies this year, Olivia. Olivia, this is your first time playing baseball with the girls. You really shocked them with your hitting. I asked a few girls what they thought about your batting, and this is what they had to say. Olivia, after your first game, you were moved up in the batting order to lead off. How did that make you feel?
I got chills, they're multiplying, and I'm losing control.
Olivia, there were quite a few plays this year where you played the ball when Erica thought they should have been her balls. What did you say to her when this happened?
Move, bitch, get out the way, get out the way, bitch, get out the way. Move, bitch, get out the way, get out the way, bitch, get out the way.
Oh, well, here comes a crowd favorite, Noella. Noella, what goes through your mind when you see Becky running?
That ass for me, shake that ass for me. Come on, girl, shake that ass for me, shake that ass for me.
Noella, we've noticed that you sometimes have a hard time hitting your cutoff from the outfield. What do you have to say about this?
I'm a real straight shooter, if you know what I mean.
Noella, at one of the games, there was no sun and it was getting darker, but you were still wearing your sunglasses. Why? Well, here comes a crowd not so favorite, Erica. Erica, how do you feel about some of the girls thinking your sister Olivia is a better ball player than you? Erica, in a game against KL Power, you made a beautiful diving catch. How did you feel about that play? Sometimes the ball is hit high over your head and you jump as high as you can, like as if you have a chance at catching it. What are you thinking when you do this?
I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night.
Well, here comes the coach's favorite, Sheena. Sheena, we've noticed that you seem to miss a lot of ground balls on the infield. A few teammates have shared some advice with you about fielding grounders. What advice did they give you? Sheena, one game, Lori was making fun of you and bending over for ground balls. What was it that she was saying to you?
Ah, that's one. One bat. Two. Two bats. Three. Three fabulous flyers. What?
Here comes another one of our newcomers, Kara. Kara, early in the season, you were running to second base and you hurt your hamstring. Stacy came to the rescue to take care of you. What was it that she told you to do? Kara, you've been kind of a utility player this year, filling in different positions as needed. How do you feel about this? Kara, in one game when you were pitching, a ball was hit back to you and there was a forced play at home plate. But rather than throw the ball to the catcher, you ran the ball home to get the player out. What was going through your mind? Ah, here comes our returning pitcher, Ginger. Ginger, you've been away for a few years now. I know the team is happy to have you back, but how did you feel coming back for your first game? Ginger, what goes through your mind when Larry calls a ball on a pitch that you believe should have been a strike?
Now we got problems, and I don't think we can solve them. You made a really deep cut, and baby, now we got heaven.
Here comes another one of the old girls, Nat. Nat, every now and then, Sheena will ask you if you can play third base. How does that make you feel?
Do I let myself worry? Wondering what in the world did I do? Oh, crazy.
Nat, we've noticed that when you get a player out, you're over the moon with excitement. What goes through your mind when you make these plays? Well, I almost didn't recognize this player, Dana. Dana, there were a few times you had a hard time catching some throws from Erica. What are your thoughts on this?
When the pimp's in the crib, ma,
drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot.
When the pigs try to get at you,
park it like it's...
Dana, you're looking pretty good this season. We know you've put in a lot of work off the field, and you've become a much faster runner. How do you feel when you run the bases now?
Chugging along, I'm here and gone like yesterday, rolling like an old freight train. On a wing and a prayer and a glorified Greyhound.
Dana, when you play first base, you like to have the players throw the ball hard at you. What do you say to them? Here comes another old player that's coming out of retirement, Anna. Anna, we know it's been a while since you've played. and maybe you've forgotten that you can't overrun second base. As you overran it and awkwardly dove to get back, the team could hear Nancy yelling. What was she yelling at you? Anna, as we mentioned, it's been a few years since you've played ball. Did you have to psych yourself up to step back on the field? If yes, what did you say to yourself to get back out there? Some girls might not know that some people refer to you as Big K because every now and then you tend to strike out. What goes through your mind when you strike out? I think I see another one of the coach's favorites coming. Tammy. Tammy, you made a comeback this year as well. Everything seems to be back to normal for you. Your batting and defense is strong as always. But I notice you have a new style of running. Can you describe it for us?
Keep the dust up. Back it on up. Fill your cup up. Let's tear it up, up. And kick the dust up. Kick the dust up.
Tammy, I recall one game where you really had to stretch to make the play at first base. How did you feel after that play?
These old bones will tell your story. These old bones will never lie. These old bones will tell you surely what you can't see with your eye. These old bones I shake and rattle. These old bones I toss and roll.
Tammy, even after all the years of not playing, your hitting is still as good as ever. What do you have to say about this? And here we have another newcomer to ball this year, Sarah. Sarah, you're new to the team and the league this year. How are you feeling during your first game? Sarah, you played the outfield most of the time, and sometimes it seemed like you had a hard time judging if you should run forward or backwards for the ball. What went through your mind when you were looking at the ball coming your way?
To the left, to the left now.
To the left, to the left.
To the right, to the right. Now take your left hand and put it on your side. Gonna roll your shoulders. Do the slip and slide. This next part's my favorite part of this time of shot.
Sarah, in a game against KL Power, you made a really nice catch against their biggest hitter. What did you have to say about that? Now, we definitely know that this is the coach's favorite, Becky. Becky, can you tell us what it is that keeps you coming back year after year?
Well, sometimes I wonder, what do I do it for? I take all I can till I can't take anymore. Still I can't walk out that door. I do it, I do it, I do it, I do it for money. I do it, I do it, I do it, I do it for money. I do it, I do it, I do it, I do it for money. Yeah, that's what I do.
Becky, once again this year, you're the oldest player on the team and still a top player in the league. Do you have any advice for the younger girls? Here comes Kevin Pillar. Oh wait, sorry, that's Jesse. Jesse, there was a game this year where you had a throat infection and didn't want to play, but the team was short, so you played wearing your mask. That night, you kept to yourself and away from the rest of the team. What were you thinking about all night? Jesse, we've noticed that when you play in the outfield, you really rely on your teammates to tell you where to go when a ball is hit to you. What goes through your mind when the ball is coming? Here comes one of the original players, Tanya. Tanya, in a recent game, you collided with Noella in the outfield. Tanya, sometimes you say you have a harder time getting to the short balls in the outfield, balls that you say you would have gotten to a few years ago. What do you have to say about these plays?
I said, girls, I ain't as good as I once was. I got a few years older now, but there was a time back in my prime when I could really lay it down.
And last but not least, here comes our final player for the evening, Alexa. Alexa, you seem to have a unique way of swinging your bat. Some would call it swinging an axe rather than a bat. What are your thoughts on this? Alexa, at the beginning of the season, the girls forgot to teach you some of the rules, causing you to get put out a couple of times. Can you tell us a bit about this?